Hey, yeah, welcome back to more wrestling news. Coming up, we're talking the latest confirmations and news regarding Extreme Rules, and WWE going wild as they are not joking about the Rey Mysterio versus Seth Rollins match. Somebody is losing an eye. The latest backstage news and even superstars stepping up to Vince McMahon in order for him to change and make new policies to take things serious. This comes when more superstars are testing positive. The real reason is finally out up to why CM Punk never joined AEW. And we are also discussing everything that went down on this week's Monday Night Raw, from Heath Slater returning to a brand new United States Championship. Anyways, hit an elbow drop and let's jump into it. Coming out of Monday Night Raw, we got new matches added to the Extreme Rules pay-per-view that is set to happen 1 week from Sunday. And as we found out, WWE is advertising a wild stipulation for one of their matches, and this doesn't seem to be a joke. While it may have sounded obvious, WWE has now confirmed that either Seth Rollins or Rey Mysterio have to put their opponent's eye out to win the eye for an eye match at Extreme Rules. This doesn't seem to be a tagline. The listing for the match on WWE.com states the following. The horror show at Extreme Rules added a new level of terror as Rey Mysterio and Seth Rollins will meet in an eye for an eye match. Rey Mysterio teamed with Kevin Owens to defeat Seth Rollins and Buddy Murphy for the right to choose the stipulation where a winner can only be determined by extracting the opponent's eye. This is wild. This is not a greatest wrestling match ever tagline. Somebody eyes is going to come out. Obviously, WWE is gonna tape this in the Performance Center, so they're gonna have enough time to edit it out and just, you know, make the graphic for whatever it is that they want to show us. They could get it done, but are they going a bit far with this? Because they do know that you cannot grow an eye back, right? This is not hair or anything like that. Once that superstar loses that eye, that's gonna be their gimmick for the rest of their career. Creative is gonna have to get real creative on this one, so I'm interested to see how it plays out. Moving into some other news, and not necessarily the best news, because Pro Wrestling Sheet is reporting that more people in the company who were at the Performance Center over the last 3 weeks have tested positive. The reports indicate that at least 30 people in total at the Performance Center have tested positive. It was indicated that over 1,500 tests have been done over the last couple of weeks, so at least now we know that WWE has been taking it serious. As we also reported, all of this has led to WWE implementing a mask policy, which will fine anyone who is not wearing a mask while at the Performance Center. Up to why this policy was implemented, it looks like Vince McMahon had no choice but to do it, as some wrestlers gave Vince an ultimatum that they will walk out if there is not a policy in place. WrestlingNews.co indicated that there were at least two WWE wrestlers who had planned on sitting out the recent set of tapings and future tapings unless a mandate was issued to have the fans, which are the developmental wrestlers, to wear a mask inside of the Performance Center. Now, FIFO reported that another wrestler who just returned from a hiatus voiced concerns to Vince McMahon about people in the company not taking social distancing and mask seriously. Report states that after this wrestler went up to Vince McMahon, the changes were put into effect. WWE has also reduced the number of people inside the Performance Center. There is also no quote-unquote friends and family as part of the live audience. We don't know which three superstars were the one that voiced their opinion and stand up to Vince McMahon about this whole issue, but massive credit to them because they actually created some change. Now it seems like WWE is indeed taking things more serious. I'm gonna take a while guess and say that I feel like at least one of these superstars was Kevin Owens. But again, no names were confirmed. That is just me taking a guess considering how vocal Kevin Owens has been over the last couple of weeks and how he seems to be one of the superstars that are really taking this serious. Moving into some quick news, congratulations to Sarah Logan as she ended up announcing that she is pregnant. This could add to the previous announcement that she made that she is currently retired from pro wrestling. All of that now seems to be a temporary thing, as obviously she's now required to step out of the industry for a bit. And to some other quick news, a new report has revealed details as to why CM Punk ultimately did not sign with All Elite Wrestling. There were reports before that he had met with Tony Khan potentially to make this happen, but that he turned down the promotion in favor of a new deal with Fox that led to him appearing occasionally on WWE backstage. But now it seems like the real reason is out, as according to Conan, who recently spoke about the talks between CM Punk and AEW, he indicated that the deal fell through not because CM Punk had turned them down because he was interested, but instead that he had simply asked for an astronomical amount of money, which ended up being too much for AEW. Conan does not specify how much money CM Punk wanted and was asking AEW for, but further went on to indicate that it was just too much for the promotion. Up to how Conan knows this information, he was negotiating with AEW last year, and this is how he ended up finding this information out. Conan even added to the fact that CM Punk had actually approached AEW with the deal, but AEW had no choice to decline. This was at the beginning of the promotion, so obviously Tony Khan couldn't just give CM Punk all of the money that he wanted and then not have anything else for any other talent. I think the main takeaway from all of this is that CM Punk hasn't been lying. Over the last couple of months, he's been indicating that he is willing to return no matter where. They just gotta pay him whatever it is that he wants. As he said multiple times, if the bag is right, he's willing to pick up the phone and talk. Jumping into Raw, it certainly started off interesting this week as we got none other than the one-man band Heath Slater returning and confronting the WWE champion Drew McIntyre. We had Drew McIntyre expecting to learn what stipulation Dolph Ziggler was choosing for their match at the horror show at Extreme Rules. But instead of that, out comes Dolph Ziggler, says that he's not going to reveal the stipulation, and instead brought out Drew McIntyre's close friend and former 3MB teammate. It wasn't a happy reunion, as Heath Slater just revealed that Drew McIntyre hasn't been keeping tab on him since he was fired. Heath Slater opened up and revealed that when Drew McIntyre got released a couple of years ago, he called Drew every single day and kept in contact with him. But then the opposite happens and he's the one that gets fired, and it just happened that Drew McIntyre has not returned the favor. It was a bit of an odd segment because they made Drew McIntyre look like a heel, as the bad guy who hasn't been checking on one of his close friends. So maybe there's a heel turn planned out for Drew McIntyre, and this is maybe the beginning of it. We don't really know just yet. Anyways, Heath Slater cut this amazing promo. He says that Drew McIntyre owes him a favor, and he wants a match. So we go to commercial, we come back, and Heath Slater gets jobbed out in less than 10 seconds as he hit a claymore kick. Drew McIntyre went for the pinfall, and that was it. Dolph Ziggler then tried to attack Heath Slater as he was pissed off, so Drew McIntyre made the save and they both hugged it out. So they are still close friends, but again, it doesn't change the fact that Drew McIntyre really looked like the bad friend throughout all of this, especially because we're talking about Heath Slater. Obviously, we're gonna get emotional with him knowing that he has been released. Up next, we get Sasha Banks and Bayley cutting a promo. They get interrupted by Asuka, who tells them that she did not come alone. So she brings out Kairi Sane. Then we get Bayley saying that Sasha Banks could take Kairi Sane on right now. So we get that match, we end in a no contest. All of this, of course, building into what will be the main event, champion versus champion. So good to see Kairi Sane back on Monday Night Raw, even though we're still getting reports indicating that she is set to walk out when her contract is done. We had the Kevin Owens Show segment with special guest Seth Rollins. We all knew this wasn't gonna go well. All of it leads to Kevin Owens teaming up with Rey Mysterio since Aleister Black were taken out backstage by Seth Rollins and Buddy Murphy. So Rey Mysterio and Kevin Owens ends up defeating Seth Rollins and Buddy Murphy to earn the right to choose the stipulation for Rey Mysterio versus Seth Rollins at Extreme Rules. A stipulation that, as I mentioned before, is a bit insane. They're gonna go at it in an eye versus eye match. And yes, WWE is advertising it like that. They are advertising it as if someone is going to be losing an eye. This is the horror show at Extreme Rules. It's not even Halloween yet, but it's is gonna be happening. We get MVP unveiling a new United States Championship, which when looking at the high quality images of it, it doesn't look that bad. It really looks like one of the best championships that they got right now, when again compare it to all of the other current titles. I still do prefer the classic one, but keeping it positive here, I do like the style of this one. Then we get Bobby Lashley and MVP defeating Ricochet and Cedric Alexander. Randy Orton, Andrade and Angel Garza defeated The Big Show and the Viking Raiders, as Randy Orton seems to be leading Andrade and Angel Garza alongside Ric Flair in what could be an awesome faction. But for the meantime, they're just teaming up, and of course they got that relationship with Ric Flair. We had Billy Kay defeating Ruby Riott, as Ruby Riott continued to have one of the worst losing streak on TV right now, or probably the worst. And then for the main event, we got champion versus champion, Bayley versus Asuka, with a lot of interruptions. So Nikki Cross was on commentary at first, but then she was taken out of the arena for a bit, only to come back at the end. So we had Nikki Cross finding a way back into the building, banging on the ringside pixel glass, which distracted the SmackDown Women's Champion and set off a change of events that led to Asuka gaining the pinfall victory. This ultimately sets up a Women's Championship match next week, as we will be getting Bayley and Sasha Banks defending their title against Asuka and Kairi Sane. It will be the go-home show of the horror show at Extreme Rules, so it should be interesting to see how it plays out. The women's tag team titles as of right now are not booked for Extreme Rules, but we do got Bayley and Sasha Banks in singles matches at the show. So that is what went down on this week's Monday Night Raw, July 6th, 2020 episode. If you guys enjoy or found the coverage informative, don't forget to elbow drop and hit those notifications to continue being up to date. Hit an elbow drop, I'll catch you on the next one, so stay savage.